Hello. Hi. Sorry, just had to grab a beer. Don't worry. I'm here. So, what is going on? We are going to do some more Angels with Scaly Wings, and we're going to do the side characters, which people have been bitching me for about forever! Holy fuck! They have been, like, the most requested thing, especially fucking Kevin, who is, like, the most out-of-place character in this game. So, without further ado, we might actually be able to make it to 24 total played hours. Because I'm currently on 21 hours. If we do some, a 3-hour stream, we'll be on 25, or on 24, on 4, on total, in total. So, we'll have played this game for a whole fucking day. So, here we are. I just have to... Okay. Thank you for doing the side characters, by the way. Well, like I said, you know, I will be doing everything and anything in this fucking game. You know, I want to have to... You know... Oh, this is one I haven't seen before. Enlightenment. That looks like Umera. I'm not sure, though. Ready to hate on Kevin's floof? I don't hate the guy! You guys just keep fucking bitching and whining about him! Which I find annoying. Okay, so... Yes, I do want to skip ahead. Because we've already seen and done this. Okay, so first we do Bryce. Hang on, is it Sebastian first, then Bryce? Or is it Bryce first, then Sebastian? Or does that not matter? Kevin can't help being floofy. He was born that way. I mean, I guess he is. I played the game for about 3 days worth. Enlightenment is Vara's mom. Oh! Well, I didn't know that. Sorry. Meanwhile, while I wait for you guys to respond, I'm going to fucking open my beer. Oh, it's because I have all the good endings? Okay, sweet. Press F to pay respects.
Where's the bottle cap? Come here! Huh?
Either way, okay, then we're gonna do Bryce first. If what people are saying doesn't matter as long as you do both. Okay, so we're gonna do Bryce first. You know, just so we can skip his path. Don't worry, Remy will respect you for going for the floof. Oh, fuck off. Well, let's go. I want to skip ahead. Because I've done this already. Sebastian first, just go straight to the new stuff? No. But it doesn't matter, TBH. Like I said, I want to get his stuff over with. Okay, so... Sebastian! You cute little fucker! Hello? Hey, Sebastian. This is Metalcore. Huh, he just hung up. You're still here? I'm still on the clock, you know. Huh, well, I'm glad you take my security so seriously. Just doing my job, sir. Oh, don't be like that with me. I appreciate it, man. Anyway, did you need anything? That's just pretty boring when I have to spend the day all on my own. I don't really know anyone here, so I don't know where I could go or what I could do for fun. Well, if it were earlier, I could have shown you around town and given you the tour. But it's getting dark outside, and I think most places are closed by now. Let me think. Do you like being outdoors? I don't think this will matter, but just in case, because I know this game does this to me! Like I said, I don't think it'll matter. But just in case... Not really. I love his adorable little hat. Yeah, his hat is cute. Oh, maybe I could change your mind about that. What do you mean? What do you think about camping? You want to go camping? Right now? Well, it might not be my best idea, but I'm not sure there's much else we could do at this time. Would it even be okay for us to just go outside? Well, I'm supposed to be guarding you, you know. Technically, I'm still on the clock, but camping would be much more fun than you just staying inside and me guarding your door, don't you think? Besides, I'm supposed to accompany you wherever you go. You're not a prisoner, so of course you're free to go wherever you want to. Yes, say yes. If you wanted to spend the night outside and experience the countryside, not only could I not stop you, but I'd be obligated to come with you. So, what do you say? Well, sign me up, man. Sure, let me just grab a few things. Well, here we are. I'm surprised we even got a spot this late after what you told me. Well, with a member of the police force and someone who is as important as you are, it's not really surprising. They probably regard it as an honor to be hosting us. So, this is it. No tent or anything? Oh, tent camping would have been a little bit more complicated to set up at the last minute. Is there any other form of camping? Well, what you're seeing here is cave camping. Essentially, they're run like hostels, but you sleep in caves like this one. Well, at least we got some furnishing. Could use a few sleeping bags, though. Well, if you wanted a comfy bed, you should have stayed in your room. This here is the real deal. Well, sounds great. Yep, just us and nature itself. We even have some natural lighting in here, so much for the real deal. Well, we could just sit in the dark if you'd prefer that. No, I think this'll do. Have you ever gone camping before? Well, not like this. I see. You know, I was kind of nervous when I met you the first time. I could tell. It was quite a thing to hear that humans were going to visit our world, but when I met you and it turned out you were just like an ordinary person, that really threw me off. By the way, Metal say that the rocks are cold at the end, very important. Didn't you meet Reza before? Actually, no. Everything about your visit is clouded in secrecy, so I didn't get to hear much about Reza from Maverick before I met you. I see. So, are you one of those who expected me to act a certain way because I'm human? Actually, that didn't have much to do with it. Any high-profile guest would have made me nervous, especially if I was in charge of keeping them safe. Tell me that this doesn't look like a scene from another game? Yeah, the game does that every once in a while. Well, I also happen to be the newest guy on the force, so I didn't exactly want this to turn into a career ender right there. Well, you've been doing pretty good so far. Thank you. I'll do my best. I'm sure of it. How long have you been on the force? They didn't assign the rookie to me, did they? Well, just because I'm the newest guy doesn't mean I'm a rookie. It's been a few years now. A few years? Well, I suppose that means you don't get many new recruits. Not here, at the very least. This is just a small town, so we don't really need them all that often. I got lucky when I got into this position because I figured there'd be more competition from the locals. Locals? Don't you live here? Well, I live here now, but I actually grew up in a small farming village that mostly consisted of runners like me. Runners? Oh, that's just what we call our species sometimes. We've got pretty powerful legs. I can see that. Are there many villages where the inhabitants are mostly of the same species? Oh, for sure. It's mostly smaller ones, though, because the bigger they get, the more variety you'll find. I see. Well, I only have my hometown to compare, but from what I've heard, there are other villages that are fairly similar. They can only survive like that if they lead much simpler lives or if they focus on a certain industry that species is good at. So, your species is good at farming? Oh, better than the Earth Dragons, at least, even though they come in handy pulling the plows. Oh, why did you decide to become a police officer? I just wanted to see what's out there beyond our vegetable fields and if whatever was there like the stories I'd heard. Is it? Oh, yes, it's been great. Now that you mention it, I don't really know much about this town either. Well, what would you like to know? let's ask about the people. Oh, they're a friendly bunch, for the most part. Of course, I also met some unpleasant fellows in my line of work, but luckily, those seem to be the minority. It was also a bit of a culture shock when I initially came here with all the different species here living together. But my police training took care of that. So, what's it like to work with Bryce? It kind of took me under his wing when I came here, and I've been working with him ever since. Pun not intended. I found it a bit weird that the big shot himself had to show the country bumpkin the ropes, though. I thought he saw it as a challenge or that he wanted to scare me away, but honestly, he's been great. Everyone here trusts him a lot. So, what's it like having that many different species? Well, compared to my hometown, it's been quite an interesting change. On one hand, you get all kinds of different people with all kinds of different strengths, abilities, and backgrounds that can make your work so much easier. On the other hand, it also creates all kinds of new problems that I never would have expected. I won't forget the first time I had to follow a shoplifter who also happened to be a flyer. Okay, about the land. The land? Well, I hear they have fertile soil. Not as fertile as my hometown, though. I was talking more about if they have any sort of industry. Oh, I see. Well, this town is actually quite unique. Because even though it's fairly small, it has its own production facility. With that, we basically have our own full production chain. So your one factory is everyone's pride and joy here? In a way, yes. It makes us fairly independent and keeps everything local. So, any recommendations or secrets? Well, secrets? This town doesn't really have any secrets. Not that I know of, at the very least. Maybe you just don't belong to the inner circle yet. I think as a member of the police force, I'd get to see everything there is to see. Either way, I don't think there's anything that special about our town. But hey, I'm not the only one who's been new here. What are your impressions? Good? Bad? Ugly? Well, it's been fun. Fun? That's not something I'd expect you to say after we showed you a corpse on your first day. Hey, if Bryce said it had to be done, then it's part of the job. I'm not sure if it was a good idea by Bryce to take you to the crime scene, though. I know he's a hands-on guy, but that really was a bit much. Pun not intended. Oh, pun totally intended, bro. Well, if you need my help, I'm glad to give it. Fostering goodwill and all that. Well, at least you don't seem to be traumatized from the experience. Anyway, how about some fun? What kind of fun are you talking about? I brought some playing cards. A staple for any camping trip. I see. What are we playing? Probably some fucking game that I don't know! Oh, just a little game called Bastion Breach. Ever heard of it? Can't say I have. Oh, we often play it in the break room to pass the time. It's good fun, though things can get quite heated sometimes. Let me go over the rules. Sure. As you can see, each of us starts with all cards of a given suit in their hand. You're diamonds and I'll be hearts. Hey, you stole all those hearts, didn't you? No, of course. What you see in the center is the middle row, which is a line of shuffled cards from another suit. This way, each game is going to be unique since the middle row always changes between games. Now, this is how the game works. We will play a round for each card in the middle row, starting with the one you see at the very left. During each round, we both decide which card to play and put it there face down, like this. Once we have both played a card, we flip them over. The highest card wins the round and whoever played it gets a point. To clarify, 2 is the lowest card and the king is the highest. The ace is a special card. It beats every face card but will lose against any number card. Now, the card from the middle row also counts. So it's possible that neither of us will get the point for a round. If there is a tie, no clear winner between the three cards, or the middle row has the highest card, no player will get a point for that round. However, the next round will give the winner an extra point to make up for it. At the end, the player with the most number of points wins the game. Did you get all that? It's pretty easy, actually. So, this game is all about bluffing and mind games. We can always see what cards have been played, so each of us knows exactly what the other player has left. Alright, are you ready? Sure. Don't worry, I'll go easy on you. Take all the time you need to make your selection. Wapum! Ah, a 5 for the first card makes for an interesting start. You could try to surpass it and play something higher, but if I'm going to do the same, you don't know how high I would go not only to beat the 5, but your higher card as well. Alternatively, you could count on me trying to beat a higher card and play a low one instead, thus making me waste mine. What is it going to be, Metalcore? Okay, I'm gonna call him on his bluff. I think he's gonna bluff for this one. Because I think he would think that he would start out strong. As you can see, I play a lowly too, just to see what would happen. Getting to know your opponent and their tendencies is just as important as analyzing potential moves and strategies. A tie. I guess we both tried to do the same thing here. You give me an achievement for winning? Well, the king presents with an interesting conundrum since we're getting him early when most cards are still available. I'll let you figure this one out, though. I'm going to keep my low card. Let me see. I don't think he's going to go all that low now, so I'm going to play a 6. Looks like a tie. Of course, the only card that beats a king is the ace, but playing it here would be a rookie mistake. It is definitely a safer play just to get rid of a low card here. Round 3. Okay, he's been playing low cards so far. So I think he would play a somewhat higher card here. So I'm gonna go for an 8. Shit. My point. Shit. Metalcore can have them. I'll stay remisexual. Hey, he's mine too, you bitch! Don't worry, you can still win. Yeah, I know you would say that. I'm gonna play a high card now. Haha! Damn! Okay, I'm gonna waste a low card here because there is no reason for... Because this is like... Hang on, no, the ace will be beat by any of these cards, so I'm gonna play me a 7. Fuck. It's not looking too great for you. I know, and playing my king here would be a waste. I'm gonna waste one of my lower cards here. This is the halfway point, so now it's really going to get serious. Anyone can still win. Okay, so he's played a 2, a 3, a 10, a queen, the joker, a 9, and a 4. So all his low cards are gone. So he only has higher cards. He has these two. He has 10. He has 8, 7. I'm gonna waste one of my lows again. Haha! Interesting. I'm gonna play high here. Fuck. Yeehaw! Shit, I don't think I'm gonna win this. The Jack? Oh, damn. I'm used to the Dutch names. And the Jack is a joker. Okay, so he has basically wasted all his high cards. Okay, so I'm gonna do a 5. I'm gonna do the 5 here. which he beats. Yeah, this game's pretty much over. So now I can play the king and the ace. Let me see, does he... No, yeah, he wins. Rip. Well, ace, which wins. And round 13, the king, and that's a closer. Alright, that's it. I'm sorry to say this, but you just lost. Yeah, I noticed. I guess I can't help it. I'm just that good. Oh, you cocky little bastard. Oh, you beat someone who played this for the first time ever. Congratulations. Why would the Jack beat the Joker when the Joker is already a separate card? Oh, yeah, that's true. I'm stupid. Don't worry. Don't be such a poor sport about it now. Maybe you'll win next time. If there ever is such a thing. I'll just put these away. No rematch? Maybe some other time. It's getting kind of late now. If you say so. Hey, maybe next time you could teach me a human card game. Yeah, sure. Maybe we should get some sleep now. I imagine it'll be just as busy tomorrow as it was today. And let's not forget, I'll have to get up early to report about all this. So, how do you like your bed of rocks? It's pretty cold, man! I suppose it takes some getting used to. A blanket would have been nice at the very least. Oh, I could warm you up. Not sure it would be safe to keep a fire burning overnight. Yeah, you know, carbon monoxide poisoning and all that. Don't want that. Mm-mm. Well, you're right, but I wasn't talking about that. I see. Either way, the only blanket I can offer is myself. I'll take it. Alright then. Is that better? Sure. Dong! Lamau. Okay, let me see. Okay, we're gonna skip ahead. I'm just gonna scroll back up just to see what. Okay, so we're gonna go Tatsu Park and grocery store now. And the rest is easy, apparently. Okay. Sebastian, best blanket. Everyone's just fucking fangasming over this guy. Okay, we're gonna have to look at the map. Go south. Well, just as I entered the southern part of the park, I found myself tumbling to the ground when someone suddenly bumped into me. Ow! Playing Angels with Scaly Wings while watching an Angels with Scaly Wings livestream. I truly am addicted to Angels with Scaly Wings. Yes, you are. I saw you were starting to play it. Oh, sorry about that. Are you alright? Lucius. Oh, besides being a little dirtier than before, I think so. I should really look where I'm going. Sometimes I just get lost in my thoughts. Hey, I think you dropped this. Oh, thank you. Ghost stories, huh? Yep. Oh, I should probably go before the bookstore closes. Bye! Bye. Oh, there's someone sitting on the benches. Then we are going to approach the dragon and we're going to do Eumera. The fat fucking dinosaur! What a most pleasant surprise to be meeting you here, Metalcore. You should go to the other area and rest on the bench too, as someone you didn't meet there yet. Okay! Do you know who I am? Yeah, you're this world's Hillary Clinton. I do. And what brings you here today, Metalcore? I'm not quite sure of that myself. Ah, the park does have an appeal that naturally draws people in. I would know, since I'm partly responsible for creating it. Have you seen the north side yet? If not, you totally should. It's just so pretty this time of year. You created this park? Well, some of it. Do you see the building behind me? That is where I work. Do you want to know a secret? The park was built here so I could enjoy going outside on my breaks, like right now, for example. Speaking of your work, Remy works for you, right? I just met him the other day. Female Geert Wilders? No! No, 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 no. Oh, Remy. Quite the little nerd, isn't he? Have you seen his malformed ears? I want to laugh every single time I see him. Well, they are pretty funny. Right? Now just imagine what it must be like working with him. He is always running back and forth on my command like some sort of well-trained, ugly, yappy dog. Can I ask you a question? Well, you can ask for sure, but whether I can answer or not is another question. Why are you such a bitch? What would you like to know? Well, let's ask about her job. Can you tell me more about your job? I could, but I think overall it's a very boring affair. It involves a lot of reading and talking and approving or rejecting forms and projects. It has its perks, but in some ways I'll certainly be happier when my term is over. If you've been minister once, that's something people will remember you for, even if those times are long past. No one can ever take that away from you again. Oh, you mentioned your term ending. How does that work here? We, the ministers, serve our term, and then someone else takes our place. Only one minister changes at a time, though. Technically speaking, any person can become a minister, though there are certain standards and requirements that must be met in order to apply for office. I don't want to bore you with the details, as that would be a long and tedious affair. Okay, so what about my visit? Oh shit, I can tell Metalcore wants to kick this bitch where the sun don't shine? Yep. Oh, what do you think about us visiting this world? You and Reza? Well, I think it is about the most exciting thing that has happened here in the last few years. It certainly has been a nice distraction from the other boring things I have to do at work. How so? Arranging your arrival was partly my responsibility. In fact, I would have been at the portal to welcome you myself if something didn't come up at the last second. And Tatsu Park? Can you tell me more about Tatsu Park? Well, I'm not so sure that there's that much to say about it. It just opened recently. I think the initial request was for more open spaces, like a dedicated place for people to gather and such. If you read the plaque, you would know that the park was dedicated to our so-called creator. I say creator because I think that word is a bit of a misnomer, but I suppose people still use it regardless. Well, that's all. I suppose I should be getting back to work anyway. Well, thank you for this most pleasant conversation, Metalcore. You know, if you wanted to continue talking at a later time, you should have no difficulty contacting me. I'll keep that in mind. Okay, so we're actually gonna go north and we're gonna just sit here. Rest on the bench. Finally, a place to sit down. Oh, the view of the scenery is perfect. You appreciated the landscape for a bit. Now you feel like everything is going to be fine. Landscaper. Sweet. That was nice. I was just about to get up when I noticed someone sitting next to me. Whoa, I didn't see you there. I thought you were a statue or something. This guy looks like a fucking Charmeleon. Oh, Jamavian. Hello? Well, maybe it is a statue. Or I just turned invisible. I hope it's not the latter. What happens if we do that again? It's like, no! So, is that all of her? Or is there more? Because if that is... I mean, if that is all, I mean, what the fuck? A Charmander, actually? Yeah, it's been a few fucking years since I've last seen Pokemon, okay? Shut up. I feel dirty when I met Emera. Charmander. No, but like I said, is that really all that's to her? Because I've seen an image. He's from the server, but he's less talkative in-game? Yeah, I know. I fucking noticed. You have to meet again later? That you need to spend time talking to her. Okay. Stop searching the park. Okay, so now we go to the grocery store. You do the same with Kevin, Katsuhara, and Zong. Who is he talking to? That's this little dragoness. Been playing the heck out- yeah, I've been playing the heck out of this game trying to get all the endings. Yeah, me too, dude. Okay, so I guess I meet with Emera now? And then the store clerk, I suppose? Arkansas and Nine have a Katsu spends opening time with them, and then Kevin opens for taking the egg, and then spends time with them. When you meet again, remember to bring a muffled gun? Oh, yes.
I mean,
I think that this would be, you know, not only more silent, but a lot more satisfying as well. I mean, it's a pretty piece of shit knife. Look at that. The blade is shit. But it's still sharp, though. I could probably do some damage to her. Which would be fucking fun, by the way. And yes, I have that on my desk. Okay, so guessing I'm doing Emera first. Come in. Well, here goes nothing. Oh, look at this place. I mean, I know I fucking hate her guts, but she has, you know, style. What a pleasant surprise. I didn't expect you to take me up on my offer. I'm sure you are a very busy person. You sure you can kill an earth dragon that easy with a knife? Hey, listen up here. I will fucking find a way, okay? Well, I have no doubt the same is true for you. I'm sorry I have to say this, but I won't have much time for you today. As edifying as your visit is no doubt going to be, I have a meeting to attend shortly. However, I'm still grateful that you came to visit. He needs the knife to rage by killing the monitor. You'll hate this part with every fiber of your being, I bet. And I'm sure someone of your standing is always busy. Thanks for taking the time to meet me. Charming as always, aren't you? So, what exactly is this? An official meeting? A trade negotiation? Oh please, this is just two people having a conversation. After all, we still owe you for the PDA devices you gave us, so until we deliver our part, there is nothing to negotiate. I see. If it would help to me, though, I'd rather listen to you all day than having to work through this stack of paperwork. Is it really all that boring? Well, sometimes. It's just an unpleasant part of the job, I suppose. In the end, working as the Minister of Culture and Arts involves just as much paperwork as any other bureaucratic position. On some days, I have to keep reminding myself that there are actual people and problems behind those numbers, and that those are the people I'm responsible for. I mean, you are a pretty big bitch to Remy, okay? Well, one mistake and those people turn against you faster than, well, something that is very fast. That is why I prefer to go where the people are, rather than being stuck back here. It makes things much clearer than the abstraction of words and numbers. Is that what this is for you? A game or a popularity contest? I may use the law, Metalcore, but I don't break it. As much as I may dislike it, a game is certainly what this is. When I came into office, it didn't take long for me to realize that you can't win if you don't play. Let me ask you one thing, Metalcore. Do you enjoy your work as ambassador? Oh, I do. Lucky are those whose purpose is enjoyable. Too bad not all of us are. Well, that doesn't sound like you enjoy your job very much, though. Well, I look at it this way. Just one term of having been on the council and I'll have left my mark. One term of being stuck behind a desk with my paperwork. At least I get to do something where I can make a difference, even if that doesn't happen very often. Culture and arts doesn't give me much room for doing what I'd want to, you know? Still, I prefer stacks of papers and meetings to working in a mine and pulling carts or logs, or whatever they would have us Earth Dragons typically do. When I look at those who have to do hard manual labor, I can't help but feel empathy towards them. I'm impressed by their tenacity to work in conditions that I would never want to. I wish to help them. I don't think you do. Well, what about those who enjoy that kind of work? Sure, but I'm not talking about them. I'm talking about those like myself who are just not cut out for that kind of job. Being in charge of your visit in this world, however, has been quite an opportunity. Was it just that? An opportunity? Of course not. I have been a staunch believer in humanism for a long time. Humanism? The belief in humans and their contribution to our existence. I see. Some people say I only took this matter into my hands as just another publicity stunt, but I can assure you that my feelings on the matter are genuine regardless. Pun intended? I would argue that making it a public spectacle only confirms my position on the matter. In the end, I don't have any hard feelings because I know the critics are only another part of the job I have to deal with. You should see how quick they are to jump at my throat and second guess every decision I've ever made. How ironic is it for people like that to have a platform where they can spout their opinions when I'm the one making all the hard decisions? That is part of your job! It doesn't matter though, I know that I will never please everyone, but my numbers do speak for themselves. In the end, it is all just a great self-sacrifice to make a difference. She's trying to flatter you? She's trying to flatter me? Yes. Is that why you became a politician? I'd like to think it was all preordained. My parents were the vehicle, so I could get this far. I always knew I was destined for greatness, just like my parents before me. And that is where you lost me. However, they thought I would need to work hard like them to get there. That's where they were sadly mistaken. I grew up as an only child in a village mostly known for its mining industry. My father was a very business-minded individual. He worked hard to provide for us and advance his career, whereas my mother was sort of more of a spiritual person. I know I'm switching my accents quite a bit, but it's hard to keep it up. After years of saving up, they combined their interests and created a new business out of nothing, a gamble that paid off handsomely. I did what was expected of me. I studied and worked hard until I came to resent it. By that point, I was at a crossroads in regards to my future career. My parents wanted me to continue my studies, but I decided against doing that. Study and working hard so that I may study and work hard ad infinitum wasn't something that was particularly appealing to me. In the end, I didn't see the difference between working hard in the mines and studying perpetually. Instead, I started to look for alternative options. There was an opening for a political position, and I decided to seize the opportunity and applied for it. At the time, I wasn't sure whether to be surprised at the fact that I got the position, but if I look back at it now, I certainly shouldn't have. I was very qualified for the job, but I also have a feeling that my parents might have persuaded those in power, because they knew this would be another step for our family. Persuaded them? How? This is only speculation, of course, but I wouldn't put it past them to do something like that, no matter if it was with words, gifts, or something else. How has that worked out for you? Well, now that I am here, the stacks of books have merely been replaced by stacks of paperwork. At least I am popular, though. Are you? Really? I know I am polarizing, but why try to please everyone and accomplish nothing when I know it's impossible to please everyone in the first place? It is a departure from the usual way of thinking, and while not liked by everyone, some of my moves have been lauded by a great majority. My strategy is to take risks that may or may not pay off when I know I have nothing to lose rather than playing it safe and just perpetuating the status quo. You have nothing to lose? I'm not afraid of political suicide because I don't value the position itself. I only value the opportunities I am given while having this power. So as long as I have it, I shall use it until I can no longer do so. My approach has been called daring or brave, just as much as it has been derided by others who don't like what I'm doing. I'm not sure if this will start a trend or if there will be others who will follow suit, but either way I'll be glad once my terms is over. What are you going to do then? People who have been on the council usually don't have trouble finding a job to their liking, but I wouldn't even need to do that. I am settled for life and could retire now if I wanted to. Retire? Is that what you would like to do? I already feel like I have left my mark and seen everything there is to see in the political landscape, so once this is over, I'd like to settle down for good and start a family. Really? I am an only child. My parents want me to make them some grandchildren and to continue the lineage. So all that responsibility rests on me now that I've proven my worth. Is that what you would like to do as well? In this case, I'll have to agree with them. Frankly, I am tired of all the work, more so than ever before. Besides, it would be a shame to let everything they built go to waste, don't you think? What is that supposed to mean? I'm talking about a family fortune, of course. And what would a family fortune be without a family? I see. The funny thing is, they were never like this when I was growing up. It was only after they had made it big that they started getting all self-important about it, illusions of grandeur included. Now that I'm getting older, I'm sad to say that it's not exactly getting easier. I probably would have had better chances if I started a family first and tried to have a career afterwards. Why is that? Being known like I am has made me popular, but it's making things complicated on the relationship front. On one hand, there are those that immediately disregard me due to my public image or my politics. On the others, we have those that are only well interested in me because of being well known. In a way, I'm getting evaluated before I even have the chance of getting to know someone, or before they get to know the person behind the politics. No matter if positive or negative, these snap judgments create a sort of proto-relationship that I have no input in, and causes them to have certain expectations or opinions about me. Well, I suppose you can't change someone's mind if they have already made it up. Would be quite a symbol if you hang her with Remy's tie. Ha! LOL. I most certainly would. Oh, you can. It's just not an easy thing to do. Not that dating isn't already complicated enough as is. Oh, maybe it'll be easier once your term is over. People may not recognize you as much. Maybe. It also doesn't help that there is a rather limited selection for prospective fathers in this town. I didn't even consider that. Maybe I'll return to my hometown once my term is over. Can I ask you something? Well, you have already asked me a lot of things since you came here. I'm sure one more wouldn't hurt. Why did you employ Remy? Well, you see, politics is a rather unusual field here. As a pursuit that mostly requires intellectual abilities, it is very open to members of any and every species who wishes to apply to such an office. However, the council members themselves are responsible for the workers they employ to help with their office duties, and that is an area where certain standards and prejudices have already started to seep in. The council members either employ members of their own species or they pick a member of a species that is stereotypically used in that area. Shortly after I came into office, I was faced with the question of who to employ to take care of the archives. I didn't really know of a suitable candidate that I wished to employ off the top of my head, so I had to make do with the applicants I received. There were numerous, among them was a number of hopefuls from my hometown who now banked on the idea I would employ them. I would employ someone I already knew, or of my own species. I could have hired one of them, but I had to realize that this decision, my first in the office, would already be under scrutiny. It certainly would have been very unusual to hire an Earth Dragon to take care of the archives, but I was sure it would have been looked at from a certain angle, with a certain bias. They would have claimed that I only employed another Earth Dragon because they belonged to the same species, or came from the same town as me. They wouldn't even consider that I made the decision based on merit. With the same biased thinking being present in the applicants, it would have been hard to find anyone among them who was actually suited to the position of working in the archives. Typically, the position is held by a species with proper hands, as is often necessary to handle small and precious objects in the archives. But since I typically do not do things the typical way, I wanted to do something different. After I sorted out applicants that only seemed to want to be there to advance their career or have something important to put on their resume, the remaining number was actually fairly small. Remy was the one that stood out to me from the rest. I wondered about his rationale to even apply for the position, given that it was unheard of for a member of his species to be the caretaker of the archives. Either he was incredibly naive or he knew that his chances were practically nil but was willing to try regardless. I was curious to find out when I invited him for a job interview. He seemed genuinely enthusiastic and had a passion for the subject, qualities I was looking for. He also had a background that actually made him well qualified for the position, at least on paper. Ultimately, he reminded me of my parents and how they managed to break out of their mold and made it big by doing their own thing. I saw an opportunity that aligned with my own goals. Of course, there were also practical considerations, but I thought with time and practice and his tireless nature, any difficulties would be overcome. Maybe he could rise above his peers just like my parents did. I only gave them the same chance. I knew I was making a gamble, but I thought with someone like him, it could very well pay off. Going against every recommendation, guidance, and advice I received, I ultimately decided to hire him, a decision that immediately made big headlines. It was the beginning of the trend that would give me the image I have now. There was a lot of coverage about it, and I think it gave Remy a lot more attention than he wanted. This might have been a good thing if he did his job well, but this didn't turn out to be the case. The first time he messed up, I made a joke about it and told him that this happens to everyone a few times. If only he had stayed at just a few times. Soon enough, my decision made more headlines from my cynical critics who lambasted me, citing his shortcomings as evidence. Of course, I couldn't go easy on him during that time. He wanted the job, so I held him to the standards of the job. If I treated him any differently, it would have only gotten worse. He might have had to work twice as hard, but if he can't do the job, maybe he isn't cut out to do it. But if he can, he'll have proven his worth to the whole town. I hear that isn't working out so well for him. Tell me about it. It is one of my few decisions that haven't ended up working in my favor, even though many people were all for it when it was initially announced. Oh, why don't you just replace him? That wouldn't be such a good idea. For one, it would only prove to the people right who doubt that I made the right choice, and secondly, it would only draw attention to the whole issue all over again. That is unfortunate. And she lost me again? Yep. Luckily, I make enough headlines these days for it not to matter much anymore. Oh, I'm going to be late for my meeting if I don't hurry up. Would you mind helping me with this? Hornshine? What is that? Just some color for my horns. You're painting them? What for? It's a public outing. Are you telling me you don't do things to make yourself look different? Well, we do. I just didn't expect your horns would be one of those things. I see. Well, the brush is over there, so get it and get going. Fucking cunt. And he says, "All right." I walked over to her table where I saw the brush among a number of other tools I couldn't quite place and a few stacks of papers. She really hadn't been exaggerating when she had mentioned her workload. Anything I need to know before I start? Not really. You know how a brush works, don't you? Well, sure do. Just so you know, I'll blame you in front of the whole council if you mess it up. Of course. I removed the cork from the glass bottle that was filled with a red, somewhat vicious liquid. After dipping the brush into it, I started painting her horn in a bright red. It only took a few applications for the horn to be covered completely. Is that good? Oh, we're not done yet. Don't forget my elbow and those on my neck. Alright. Here, that should do it. Let me take a look. She walked up to a mirror and turned her head a few times so she could see herself from every angle. Basically, she used Remedy as publicity, but now he isn't useful to her. She's trying to make him quit by bullying him then? Yeah, that is basically what she's doing. Not too shabby, Metalcore. Maybe you would make a good assistant. Oh, hells no! Maybe. Anyway, how does it look? What do you think about the color? I would have painted a dick on her mouth? Yes. Goes well with your makeup and jewelry, I guess. Oh, thank you. That's exactly what I was going for. You know what? All that sitting around is making my back so horribly stiff. Would you mind giving me a massage? I could certainly use one right now. Oh, not at all. Even though everything is saying that I should fucking go? I'll do it, I guess, you fucking cunt. You're a real lifesaver, Metalcore. I know it's a strange request, but having to sit in this office for hours on end working through all these papers takes its toll on my body. You know, my kind tends to be very physical, and I haven't quite gotten used to this office lifestyle yet. The last thing you'll ever see is a Remy smile down at you while you're dying? Yeah. She lay down on a mat and pillow she had quickly produced from somewhere and presented her back to me. I briefly wondered if she kept these items in the office for occasions just like this one. You can hear this is killing metal? Yes, it is. So, what should I do? Well, you can start at the neck and work your way down. Well, I don't know much about massaging an earth dragon. What kind of movements are we talking about here? Well, just put your palms on it and start rubbing in circles. And don't hold back, I assure you we earth dragons can take anything you dish out. Alright, study your anatomy and look for weak spots? Exactly. Hang on.
I gotta grab my phone.
I had to charge it real quick, because it was, running out of power. Hang on just a second! Should have drawn dick butt on her horn? Lol. I was about to ask her if I was doing it right when I heard her voice. Oh yeah, that is lovely. Just be careful around the spines. I think we both don't want this to end with an impaled hand. Then RKO out of nowhere or just body slam her? What about Zweihanders or Claymores? I prefer Dreihander. I don't know what that means, but I guess it's, fun. Well, after she had mentioned them, I couldn't help but wash her spines a little bit more closely while I continued my ministrations. They seemed to be made from the same material as the horn on her muzzle. Even though they were not as girthy, they still started out with a rather wide base, ultimately accumulating in a point that didn't seem sharp enough to cause any damage by accident. When I resumed my treatment, she suddenly buckled. She suddenly bucked, her spines only missing me by inches when she suddenly threw her head up. I guess she wasn't kidding about watching out for the spines. Fearing a bit for my safety, I moved down to her shoulders. Oh, your hands are wonderful, Metalcore. Is that so? Mm-hmm. The movements, the incomparably soft skin on your hands. I'll take it as a compliment. Mm. Oh, it most certainly is. I moved further down to her back, noticing the increased roughness and armor that covered her there. Oh, don't hold back now, Metalcore. Put your strength into it, or I won't even feel a thing. Following her guidance, I increased the pressure from my palms more and more. Oh no, I refuse to read this! I refuse to read that. No! I gave it everything I could, and as I kept going at her, I noticed the muscles beneath her armor softening noticeably. No! Apparently I do. By this point, I had moved down to her hips, giving them the same treatment as with the rest of her body. I hear slight squishing sounds and I don't like that! This shit writes itself? Press V?
Self-voicing enabled.
Just skip?
Self-voicing disabled.
Oh, this is done wrong! Unrelentingly, I continued, vowing not to stop until every last knot in her muscles was gone. No! Tenderizing her like a rump steak? No! Dude, am I turning green right now? No! No! Her hips that was soft and supple as a jello-filled beanbag? I am just going to skip through all this. I know... What an interesting lady! The politician! Oh, I feel dirty. I feel dirty! I feel violated! Someone please! I am not nearly drunk enough for this shit! Like I said... The face of a broken man full of shame. Yes. Okay, well, we're going to meet with the store clerk now. You know you wanted that? Oh, hells no! Angela Merkel? Ha! Pretty much. Well, where is he? Anybody here? Oh, there you are. Everyone's thrown up in the chat. Suddenly he grabbed my hand and bowed to plant a wet kiss on it with his snout. Ew! Hello, Metalcore. I'm sorry, but I don't think we've actually been properly introduced before. What was your name again? Oh, you can call me Zong. Where is everyone? Well, the bar is already closed and everyone's gone home, so it's just us. I see. Wait, is that Bryce sleeping under the table? Oh, you're right. Guess we're not alone then. If you listen to every song on the jukebox, you get an achievo. Sweet! Does this happen often? Sometimes. Well, you should start charging him rent. That's an idea. Maybe then I wouldn't have to work two jobs. Right, what is up with that? They're both just part-time, so it's no big deal. I see. Which one do you prefer? It's hard to say, really. Bartending is more fun, but working in the store plays better and is also more stable. At least you get to wear a uniform in both. That doesn't exactly seem common around here. Yeah, they're usually very simple. I like this one, but after a while the collar can get a bit tight around the neck. I bet you like being choked, don't you? You fucking weirdo. Well, the store uniform is just a chore to get on. The hat, the apron, it all feels a bit constricting. Well, you look kinda cute in it, though. Oh, you think so? Ah, the blush! The blush! LOL! Well, that's a new one. It was interrupted by a loud snore that came from under the table. When I looked down, I saw it was Bryce turning over in his sleep. Oh, what, Bryce? You want another beer? Sorry, mate, but the bar's already closed. Isn't he wonderful? Or is it a bit rough? Well, let's hope he doesn't get rid of any liquids. Oh, don't worry about that. I have my trusty mop for situations like that. Hopefully you won't need it tonight. It's just another part of the job. I'm pretty used to it by now. Oh, you seem to know Bryce pretty well. How long have you known each other? Well, since childhood, really. We both grew up here. If you think he's a bit rough now, you should have seen him in his youth. Such a troublemaker. But you could rely on him for anything. I trust him with his life. Seems like a lot of people have confidence in him as the chief of police. They do, and rightfully so. The things he's done for me personally were way beyond his duties, the mark of a true friend. What did he do? Oh, it's a long story. It has more to do with myself than him, really. Oh, come on, you can't just start like that and not spill the beans. Well, if you say so. Cleaning up dragon piss? Yep. Well, I was adopted when I was merely a hatchling. It's really not as big a deal to me, and never really came as a surprise to anyone, considering my parents aren't even the same species as me. My family isn't originally from around here. I heard you were being mean to Zong, I would wreck you if you are? I wasn't. Did he get the line about the mop? Yes, I did. Oh, my father got a job around here, so we relocated. Moving across the continent meant losing all my friends, and making new ones wasn't easy for me. I was young and new and just a little scared. Even back then, Bryce was a very curious fella, especially when other people were involved. He came up to me in school, introduced himself, and we've been friends ever since. Many years later, Bryce was already on the force, and my desire to find my biological parents had grown so much that I made some efforts to find them. Bryce pulled a few strings, and with his help, I was able to track them down. He even accompanied me on the trip. Do you want me to come inside as well? No, just stay here, all right? Sure. I mustered all my courage and went up to the door of their run-down home. Knock, knock! Hello? What do you want? Hello, is this the residence of Wang Fu and Xiu Jing? Who wants to know that? Well, about 20 years ago, you gave up your child for adoption and... Slam! Oh, no. You know what? I'm not dealing with this right now. We didn't give you away so just so you could show up whenever you please. And don't even think of calling me father. I won't. Wow! Rude! He turned around and went back inside. Just as he was about to close the door again, another person appeared next to him. Don't be rude, Wong. Come in for a tea or something, alright? Alright. I mean, I wouldn't even want to, honestly. Like, okay, you're gonna be like that? Well, fuck you then. Like, you are not worthy of both my attention and my time. I hear cars in the background. Here, sit down. I'll go and make us some tea. What a cock, dude. Wow. Here you go. Don't you want to join us, Wong? You invited him in. He's your guest, not mine. I don't want to have anything to do with this. I guess he doesn't want to talk. Guess so. Maybe he's not ready yet. Maybe. I guess 20 years isn't long enough. Look, I want to say I'm sorry, but I know nothing I can say can make up for what happened. We had to give you away because we were young and stupid. These days, we aren't young anymore. How do you like the tea? It's alright. Oh, I've got something for you. She got up, walked away from the table, and vanished into a different room. Wang Fu was sitting on a couch nearby in front of the TV, his eyes glued to the screen. After a few moments, Kua Ying returned and joined me again. Here, take this. What is it? It's a hat we got you when you were little. It's one of the few things we still have from back then. Thank you. You want some more tea? No. Okay. I don't want to ask you this, but do you have some cash to spare? We really need some food and Wong doesn't like to go hunting. So you do that. You abandon him as a child. Then, when he comes looking for you, the father basically just says, no, fuck off. And now you have the gall, the guts, to ask him for money? Are you fucking joking? Wow, you are scum. You are absolute scum. I am sorry, but I would just, you know, I wouldn't even say anything. Just like, just walk out before I start throwing fucking fists around. Because that is something you do not ask under any circumstances after you've gone ahead and done this. I just brought enough for the trip back home. I don't think that... Oh, you don't have anything? Then what are you still doing here? You can watch TV but not provide for your family? What a man. The mother asked for money? Well, both of them. I mean, it doesn't matter. Get out of my house! No, please. Yeah, maybe it is time for me to go. I don't even think of coming back! How dare you come here and disturb us like that? And he has the guts to be mad at him. Do you even know what you just asked for? What you just did? Is there a problem here, sir? Who the heck are you? Police, it sounds like you might have some trouble here. Perhaps one of a domestic nature? Not at all. I'm sorry, Zong. He doesn't know what he's doing. Oh, no! Oh, no! No! This guy knows exactly what he's doing. Well, I can see that. Come on, Bryce. Let's go. You done? I think I've seen what I need to. Alright. Dude, I was not ready for that! I cried so much that day. I'm sorry to hear that. Not that it matters much anymore, it's all in the past. But Bryce, he's been there for me when I needed him then, and he's still here today. Well, except for the part where, in a way, he's responsible for the whole town now. How's he handling it? Pretty well, I'd say. Everyone trusts him and thinks he's doing a great job. Dude. One goes out for you, man. Anyway, let's put on some music. Give the old jukebox a little whirl. Sure. He got up and walked over to the jukebox in the corner to look at the selection. Let's see. What kind of music do you like? Actually, I'm not sure if your music is in any way similar to ours. Let's just put on a few different songs and you tell me what you think, alright? Press H to hug Zong? Yeah, dude. H up in the chat, man. Sure. Feel free to pick anything that strikes your fancy. Let's try some rock. Without further ado, here we go. This is pretty good. Do I have to sit through all of them? And like all the way? Play them all? Sure. Get sit back, relax. and that's some of my fucking beer. I love the rock song. Yeah, dude. It's pretty good. Let's want to keep the stream progressing. Okay. Oh, is it too loud for you? I didn't consider your ears maybe more sensitive than ours. Let's just try something else. Okay, I want to hear orchestral. This one's a bit slow, so you'll have to wait a while for it to get going. All right. Okay, cool. Well, that's pretty decent. It's one of my favorites, actually. Oh, really? Yeah. Okay, let's listen to some piano. Know what a piano is? Of course I do. Well, not really. Not that many can, actually. There are many kinds of instruments that can only be played by certain species, you see. It doesn't stop until you hit stop anyway. Okay. Well, makes sense. All right, now listen to this. Oh God, this is feelsy. No! Didn't you like it? It's all right, I just want to try something else. I see. This is some classical, of course. Now this one's a real classic. I think it's one of the oldest songs we know about. They didn't include dubstep. Okay, cool. Want to hear something else? Alright. Okay, electronic. This is something a bit more modern. Yeah, this isn't really my style. What do you think? That makes for nice background music, I'll give it that. Maybe not for the bar, though. Okay, and soundtrack. Now, this is something a bit different. It's from the soundtrack of some video game, I think. Eight bit. Whoop! That piano theme plays during other parts of the game? Oh, sweet. That's not really my kind of music. Certainly unusual. You listen to a bunch of music just for the achievement. Admit it. What kind of music do you like anyway? I like a bit of everything, really. I actually collect all kinds of music and paraphernalia, and the jukebox is curated by me. Dragon dubstep, Emerus face hitting repeatedly against the desk, wall, and floor? Well, sometimes people even donate some stuff they don't need anymore. I'm pretty well known among the patrons for it. Is the stuff on display over there yours too? I'm actually trying to sell those. You're selling your collection? I'm only downsizing. That's just a player and a few old records I'm trying to sell for my holiday fund. Oh, where are you going? It's going to be a family holiday, just my son and myself. Mainly for my son, though. We're planning to travel across the whole country, making stops in various cities along the way. I've been planning it for a while now and trying to save up to make it happen. We could never really afford a vacation while his mother was still around, so... What happened to her? I wish I knew. We fought a lot back then, about all kinds of things. When I think back to that time now, it seems like that was all we did. Argue about petty things that people don't need to argue about. Of course, it's easy to say that after the fact, and when it's already too late. Buy them! Fund his dreams! I never would have thought it was bad enough to warrant doing what she did, though. What did she do? One day, she was just gone. Packed up her things and left in the dead of night. I don't know where she went or what became of her. In the end, I think she just wasn't ready to be a mother. And this was almost 4 years ago now. But yeah, that's why I think we need that holiday, to spend some quality time together. It's also why I took that second job in the grocery store. He's going to turn 9 in a few months, and I want to surprise him with it then. You saw this movie where a family goes on vacation across the country and all kinds of crazy hijinks happen along the way. He loved it so much and asked me all the time when we were going to go on a vacation like that. I just want to give that to him. I think he needs it. Oh, you said his birthday is in a few months. Will you be able to afford it? Oh, more than halfway there already. With the second job, it really shouldn't be a problem. I'd just like to have more than a buffer, because I think this holiday will have all the bells and whistles you can imagine. I see. Kiss him! Become the second father! How about I buy some of those records? Really? Well, you said they're for sale, right? Yes, but... I'll just put it down as expenses in regards to my visit here, so it'll all be taken care of. You would do that? Maybe, after you play me some of that music, I just can't resist and need those records for myself. Actually, I'll need the player too, because I doubt those are going to work with our own players back home. Besides, I could really use a souvenir. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Let me just get that for you. Here you go. Oh, I could try to give it back? Let me try to give it back, just as a sign of goodwill. You know what? Why don't you keep it? What do you mean? Well, what if I wanted to donate this back to your collection? Oh no, that would be too much. It's yours. Please, take it. All right. Besides, these aren't so special that they need to be part of the collection. Otherwise, I wouldn't be selling them. Okay, I get it. It'll also be interesting for humanity to have, I think. Oh, for sure. Maybe you could show me some human music in return sometime. Deal. So I suppose you're back in the game now, huh? Game? What game? I mean dating. Oh, what makes you think so? Oh, what's all this? What'd you ask me out? Oh, you seemed like a nice person. I wanted to know what you're like. Do you kiss the hand of every nice person you meet? I guess you got me there. I suppose that makes my intentions rather obvious, even though I know it won't last. He'll be happier if you take them? Well, whatever. I already did the thing. Besides, I'm not sure if I'd call it a game. That's something that Rice would do. I prefer to take things slower in an everlasting relationship. Oh, Zong, you're a man of my heart, bro. I agree. I see. Oh, why'd you ask me out if it's not going to last, though? Oh, Bryce told me about you, you know? It made me realize I've got to go get out there again. So the first thing you do is ask out the strange visitor from an exotic place. Be honest, did you just ask me out because I'm a human? Not only. I figured you could tell me more about how humans date and give me some advice. I'm not sure if my experience would be worth anything here. Oh, you're bound to have a different perspective of everything that goes on here. Maybe you pick up on a few things we haven't considered. I just want to hear your opinion. Well, it's not just about dating, you know? Well, let's talk about dating if you're interested in that. I doubt I'd be able to have a frank discussion about this with anyone I meet here. Alright, I think by now you've got a taste of about how Bryce is with these kinds of things. He likes messing around. It seems like he's got someone new every couple of months. You should see him on some nights and how people just swarm around him. Can't blame him for that, though. He's a popular guy. Do you envy him? No, I don't want what he has, but I'm finding it hard just to find that one prospective partner. You'd think I'd pick up on these things while working, but then it's typically not long-term relationships that are formed here. I see. I don't exactly have that much free time to put myself out there. I'm also not getting younger, and don't forget I already have a child to take care of. That doesn't make things easier, you know? In a way, you're not just dating the person, you're also dating the kid, if you know what I mean. What? Now that just sounds wrong. Oh, shush. It can make things rather difficult, that's all. Alright, maybe we'll have to work on your approach. What's the first thing you notice about a person? Their personality. Really? I meet so many new people here every day. When they're customers, the thing that always stands out about them is mostly how they treat their servers. I see. Besides, I'm not interested in relationships based on looks. I like talking to people and getting to know them that way. Well, this also makes the whole thing harder for me because I have to invest a lot more time to find out if we're compatible. You know, if a relationship doesn't work out for Bryce, he can just find someone else the next day, but for me, this process can take a few months. I can imagine. I don't think there's a recipe for success I can give you, though. Why not? Well, you seem to be doing pretty well already. You're nice and polite. I don't think you need to do anything different. Is that what you think? Yeah, sure, it may take a while to find someone, but I don't think there are any shortcuts for what you're trying to do. Just keep going and it'll happen eventually. Besides, you've got some time to figure out things for yourself with your vacation coming up, right? That's true. It'll be an eye-opening experience in a number of ways. Maybe the relationship run is going to be one of them. No, that's the right attitude. And on that note, maybe we should call it night. It's pretty late. Yeah, you're right. Well, thank you for the wonderful evening. Likewise. Not to mention the advice and for buying my stuff. You're welcome. Be safe, take care, and maybe I'll see you some other time. Maybe. A song, baby, I'm compatible with you. Bum bum bum. Okay, so... Okay, we do all this, I'm fine. We are going to skip ahead. Okay, so now we've done those, I think we need... skip it up a bit, where is... Okay, so we only have Katsuhara and Kevin, right? If that is correct. Go to the police archives, but help the state help Katsu. Look at the gallery. Well, I'm gonna... Okay, Katsu! I'll help you, bro! Hop! I'm gonna stay inside. Okay, we're just gonna wait it out. We are going to get that fucking ice cream. I will get all the diabetes. Oh, I can actually listen to my records. That's pretty neat. Okay, we are going to meet with the Katsuharu. There you are. I wasn't sure if I was going to find you from the description you gave me. Well, this corner's where I do business. You could have asked anyone and they would have told you where to find me. I see. Now, what would you like for your ice cream? Well, what do you have to offer? What I have to offer? As for the main dish, I have ice cream, gelato, frozen yogurt, frozen custard, soft serve, sorbet, sandwiches, popsicles, Millerin, sorbet, cold taffy, snow cones, and Halo? What? Alright. For sides, I can offer you waffles, sticks, pretzels, cups, vapor cones, cake cones, sugar cones, chocolate coated cones, double cones, or vanilla cones. That's a lot of variety out there. And I haven't even started on about the toppings. Now you know why I have to keep dragging this big cart everywhere. Excuse me? I'm sorry, but we're closed. You don't look closed. But we are. I really want to buy an ice cream though. Please, it's really hot and I'll pay you twice as much. Sorry, we are closed. Can you at least tell me when you're going to be open? When I feel like it. Now, off you go. I recommend a loan. Oh boy. But... Katsuharu waved the claw dismissively. Off you go. Sheesh, whatever. I'll just go and jump in a lake or something. He probably needs to do a loan for time issues, I guess. Waifu! Why did you come in when you're closed? This is just my spot. Has been for a long time. I'll open for those pesky customers later, but right now I have a guest to entertain. I see. How long have you been doing this? Well, I've been in this business for over 40 years now. Oh, wow. You see, I'm this town's only real ice cream vendor. Sure, you could just go into a store and buy any pre-made ice cream nowadays, but it's just not the same. My customers know that. They love my ice cream. It's like, no, you can't swim! Of course, I don't just sell it. I also do ice cream parties and catering. Ice cream parties? Only for very special occasions. Well, the townsfolk must really like your ice cream then. Oh yes, business has been wonderful for decades. Lately though, everything just seems to be going down. I want to watch Bryce go swimming? Oh hells yeah, dude. Well, why's that? Every day, less customers find their way to me. If I don't sell everything, things start to spoil and I have to throw them away. I've never had to do that before. If it keeps going like this for much longer, I might have to face the reality of bankruptcy. I was planning to retire in a few years, but I can't. Not like this. It wouldn't be nearly as bad if I hadn't also lost my savings recently. Oh no, what happened? Well, I happen to be an avid player of a game called Mahjong, and just as so happens, sometimes people play it for money too. I don't know if you're pressed for time. You lost all your life savings by gambling? That's the funny thing about gambling. Sometimes you win and sometimes you don't. Sometimes you win big and sometimes you lose all your savings. That's just how it goes. I see. How did you decide to become an ice cream vendor anyway? I have quite a history, human, so I'd hope you're prepared. Well, I am an ambassador, so if you have a story to tell, I'll listen. As you wish. This is gonna take a while, isn't it? I have very fond memories of my childhood. When I was little, we had a confectioner in town who offered all kinds of specialties, from cookies and sweets to cakes and chocolates. The owner was a kind old dragoness who made everything that was sold in her shop with her own two claws. Her confectionery was also very good. Was always very good, but it was her ice cream that was truly exceptional. Even as a small child, I could always taste the difference, even when my peers didn't care and proclaimed one ice cream as good as the next. As I grew up, I came to a fundamental understanding about people. There are those who are content with the lowest common denominator, and those like me who could appreciate the finer details in expertly crafted things. Oh, yes! I talked with her when I heard of her plans to retire, to see if someone else was to continue running the shop, or if she had taken in an apprentice. But to my utter dismay, I learned that this was not the case. You see, she was the kind of humble person who didn't think of herself or her wares as special in any way, so she never felt the need to preserve them. I realized that without my intervention, her art would be lost forever. Well, I begged and pleaded with her not to let this happen, but she insisted that I had vastly overestimated her skill. It was not until I ran out and brought her some of the store-bought pulp they dared to call ice cream that she gave in and agreed with me. As a creator, she of course had never felt the need to buy some for herself when she could just make her own. And after only eating her own wonderful ice cream for all these years, it had just become normal for her. She had never realized how exceptional it truly was. Even though she was already at retirement age at the time, she took me in as an apprentice to teach me the fine art of confectionery. I was her student for a few years and learned the basics of many different recipes, but unfortunately, she passed away before I could learn the secrets to her particular blend of ice cream. For the next couple of years, I traveled from city to city, trying to find her relatives or confectioners of a similar caliber in order to find the last ingredients of her recipe. Going from one disappointment to the next, I finally tracked down a distant nephew who remembered her from his own childhood. Even back then, her ice cream had apparently been very popular in the family. He was very happy to hear that she was able to fulfill her dream of owning her own confectionery. However, after he told me that the recipe was the confectioner's own, and that she had never divulged it to anyone else, I had to realize that this was a secret she had apparently taken with her to the grave. Nowadays, people tell me that I have surpassed her. What they don't know is that all the different recipes I use, all the varieties I offer, came to be when I tried to recreate her recipe. I never succeeded. Just look at the number of different ice creams I sell. People tell me how impressive that is and how they're all wonderful. They think it makes me better than her, but she only ever sold a single flavor, a single variety. She never needed anything else because that one flavor was perfect. I can only ascribe my own success to what I learned from her. Of course, this corner is not only the only place where I sell the ice cream, I also have my spots in the surrounding villages. But even then, I can slowly see the influence of the cities taking over. The trouble is, nowadays people just don't appreciate the art anymore. They only care that with the... They only care that they can eat, and not about what they eat. They are too quick to settle for what they can get from the local supermarkets. Ugly, mass-manufactured pulp. Ah. You know, some of those companies have approached me before. They wanted to buy my recipes, but I won't let them ruin what I have by making it cheap and easy to produce like the stuff they sell. My ice cream is only what it is because I still make it myself with my own two hands. This is the way it has been and how it's always going to be. Oh, you mentioned you were planning to retire in a few years. What's going to happen then? Do you have any students though who will take over the business afterwards? The dragon gave a big sigh. I wish. I've had a few students who wanted to learn the art, but they all gave up sooner or later. Why is that? I may be very forgiving, but the recipes aren't. Some steps require manual labor, and people don't expect the harsh conditions that come with the job. Many apply only because they know how successful I am, or how much I sell on a hot day, but they don't see all the work that goes on behind the scenes. I see the same influence of the cities corrupting the youth of today. They are lazy and seek instant gratification, wanting to make the recipes easier and cut corners. But I won't stand to compromise on quality. If there is no one willing to learn, appreciate, and preserve the art, it will tell me that there is no desire for my ice cream in this world anymore. Let them have the cheap stuff if that's all they want. I'd rather take my recipes to the grave than let the big companies have them. I have a grandson who may be my last hope. Unlike others, he was always interested in not only eating my ice cream, but also in learning what it took to make it. In a year or two, he'll be old enough to become my apprentice if he so desires. I'm not sure if his interest will still be present. Even if it is, I don't know if he will be able to brave the hardships that come with it, but I have hope. However, that is talk for the future. I have much more pressing problems now. Like what? Well, you see, this area used to be the popular spot for people to meet each other, but ever since Tatsu Park opened, it is not worth it to come to my corner anymore. The store is closer now. Well, maybe you shouldn't count on the people seeking you out. You should try coming to the people instead. That's what a card is usually for, right? Have you tried moving it somewhere else? Moving? Well, that's what the wheels are for, right? But this has been my spot for the last 40 years. It's always worked out great for me. Well, considering it's not working out so great right now, maybe it's time for a change. The dragon raised a claw to his chin, his expression telling me that he was deep in thought. I guess I don't really have anything to lose at this point. What do you propose? Well, like I said, just set up at Tatsu Park. I got... There we go. I'm not sure how I let you convince me to come here when this is the place that stole all my customers from me. I don't think that's the right way to look at it. The world is ever-changing, and you can't stop that. You have to find ways to deal with it, or else you'll be left behind in the past. It's too easy just to blame the change and be done with it. You shouldn't really be so quick to give up, you know? But all my customers know that the other corner is my spot. How are they going to find me here? I think the people who will buy some ice cream will spread the word. You think so? It's summer. I'm sure there are tons of people around who would like to buy an ice cream right now. Well, if you think you can sell ice cream better than me, then please go right ahead. What do you usually do? What do you mean? Well, what's your usual sales tactic? I don't need to do anything special. People always used to come to me. During my best times, they'd wait for my arrival in lines and I'd be sold out in minutes. I see. That may have worked before, but these times call for different measures, I think. We set up the cart at one of the busier corners. Once it was ready, we only needed to get the word out. Ice cream! Ice cream! Ice cream by the one and only Katsuharu, right here in Tatsu Park. Get some while supplies last! It didn't take much to make the people in the vicinity take notice. The first customers arrived quickly. Of course, everyone recognized Katsuharu and loved his ice cream, but they also commended him on this new location. Others, however, were attracted by me. The human that was generally under police protection openly selling ice cream gave people plenty of excuses to come over for a short chat. Soon people were flocking to the cart as word got around of the human selling Katsuharu's legendary ice cream in Tatsu Park. Anyone else craving ice cream? I kinda am now. Could I get one of these, please? Of course, one ice cream for my favorite art student. How did you know? I've seen you around. Besides, your accessories kinda gave it away. Oh, okay. I need some ice. My colleagues are dehydrated from working in the heat. How many cups would you like? Let's make it 10. Alright, here you go. 10 cups plus one extra. Just for you. Thank you. I'll make a count. Business was booming, but it wasn't until a certain person showed up that things were about to get serious. Umura. Well, this is interesting. Minister? What do you think you're doing here? Well, what does it look like? It looks like you're selling ice cream, and since I personally know Katsuharu, I know that it's exquisite ice cream at that. Not a bad guess. I don't want to tell you what to do, but if the Trade Commissioner finds out about this, I won't hear the end of it. He'll probably be blathering about unfair competition and abuse of your status. I wouldn't mind his complaints, you know, but since I'm in charge of your visit, it's all going to come back to me, and he's going to want an explanation. I just wanted to help Katsuharu, that's all. Help him? Is he in trouble? Alas, the human speaks the truth. Ever since the opening of Tatsu Park, my business has been plagued by drought and become forsaken like a desert. Well, it's not hard to see why when you kept staying at your old spot on the other side of town. Well, it was Metalcore's idea to come here. And it was a good one. You don't look like you're having much trouble here at all, my friend. Yes, I will have to admit defeat on that front, but in hindsight, all successful ideas look like good ones. My friend, how come you never told me about any of this? I could have arranged something for you. I was sure you had more troubling issues yourself than taking care of a businessman who should be able to take care of himself. Well, I won't stand for this town's only ice cream vendor going out of business. With this new location, I don't think I'll have any more trouble. But in order to resolve this little situation right here now, I think I'll have to go with a different solution. You want to sell some ice cream, Metalcore? Then I'll just have to buy the rest of your inventory. Oh, Minister must be very hungry then. Or very hot. Maybe both. I'm sure the other employees in my building will appreciate a little something to combat the heat. Would you mind if I borrowed this cart for a while? Otherwise, I'm not sure how I would go around about transporting it all safely. Not at all. Just let me know when I can retrieve it. Of course. Well, that was interesting. This could have hardly turned out any better for me. I can already feel the excitement of my glory days returning to these old bones of mine. It sounded like you two knew each other. Indeed, I have served her ice cream since the beginning of my career. Talk about a long-time customer. And a good one, too. I know she not only has enjoyed my ice cream out of tradition or necessity, but also due to an appreciation of the finer arts. She is a connoisseur, like me. And she bought the whole inventory. Yes, but don't just see her as a big spender. She is a true patron of the arts. I mean, her office sure looks nice. Do you like her? Oh, how dare you say something like that about her? She is a muse, an inspiration. Her lifestyle embodies the philosophy of my art. And you ask if I like her? Pah! I see how it is. Anyway, I guess I should be thanking you for the help. Again. Well, there's no need for that. I'd offer you some more ice cream, but I'm afraid we're all out for the day. Actually, I didn't even have one earlier. What? Yeah, that customer you didn't want to serve interrupted us, and now Amira took the rest with her. Oh, you're right. What a great shame. You sold all my stock, yet you didn't get a chance to indulge in the luxury yourself. That's no big deal. You know, you could come by next time when I'm in town again. Now that you have saved my business, I'd let you eat all the ice cream you want. Katsuhari is now a happy noodle. Thanks. Well, maybe not all of it, or else I might go bankrupt again. You met with Katsuhari and saved this business, but who wouldn't at the prospect of free artisan ice cream? The artisan. Yeah, boy! We made a happy noodle. I wonder if he's a tasty noodle? Let's see if we can listen to some of the records. Oh, this is these songs. Oh, sweet. Press N to make the noodle rich. Happy noodle is tasty noodle. It tasty. Okay, well, we're going to get some well-deserved rest, and then we're going to do the last chapter. Okay, we've done all of this. Okay, now Sebas. Okay, if it's that important to you, then why don't you just watch it regardless? Are you suggesting I abandon my post during the fireworks? No, you don't have to abandon your post, but if you pick a good spot and watch them for like half an hour or so, no one's going to care. I'm not so sure about that. The guard post is pretty important. I know we're talking about the portal, but you don't need to take this so seriously all the time. Just think about it. The portal is broken right now anyway, and everybody will be busy watching the fireworks. Nothing is going to happen. I suppose you have a point. Just pick a good spot and no one is even going to notice you're gone. Well, if you say so. Anyways, I should get back to the investigation now. I'll leave the stuff for you here, and I'll take care of the rest once I get back, alright? Sure thing. Cough, that customer had a name? What customer? Good luck, Metalcore. You too. Okay, so we're going to take the edge to the hatchery, and we're going to get to Kevin. Here's Kevin! Oh, it was Bryce, yeah. Alright, well, why don't you come over to my place later? I'd love to hear more about what your college is all about in this world. Oh, then you found the right person for the job. I can't promise anything right now, but maybe I'll see you another time. For sure, I also have to finish this up here, but after that I'm free. Right, I'll let you know. I'm here all day today and tomorrow, so it shouldn't be hard to find me. Great, I'll have to get going now, but I'll be sure to let you know if anything's up. Sure, see ya. The fair dragon, oh boy. Oh boy! Tell that to Sebi for the entire time? Finally! I'm gonna be a lazy fucker. Wow, Metalcore, you forgot the Bryce price that easily? I mean, he forgot me pretty easily as well. Skip ahead. Yo, Kevin! Get over here, bro! Furball McKevin finally gets some love? Yep. That must be him. Floofball? Yeah. Hello. Oh, good to see you again. This is where you live, huh? Well, for the time being. Thought I saw a cat. Oh, that's pretty nice for a small town like this one. Are you not from around here? No, I'm just here for the job until the next semester starts. Basically, I'm trying to drum up interest for the college and see if there's anyone around who'd like to apply for it. Look at that chest bloof. Furries confirmed, I guess. Well, how's that working out? Well, I haven't actually met that many candidates out here so far. For a town like this one, it is typical for the young people to go into an apprenticeship to prepare for their future job rather than go to college. But if there's anyone willing, we want to find them. Even out here? Yeah, there's always that need for more highly educated people in the cities as they expand. Kevin's music is chill? Yeah, it is. The cities? That's the first I hear of cities in this world. I thought this town was where it is at. You hear it all over your sofa already? Nah! Oh, then you've really been missing out. This town isn't really all that special when it comes down to it. I've lived in the city for most of my life. Of course, that is also where the college is. I don't think they'd build one out here anyway. I think as ambassador they'd show me around a bit, but apparently that isn't the case. Well, your visit is a bit of a political issue right now. The bottom line is that it's also for your own protection. Everything surrounding the portal has been a well-kept secret. People know that it exists and that we currently have human visitors, but the exact location is only known to those who live here. If it ever got out, I don't think this town couldn't face the ensuing torrent of tourists trying to catch a glimpse of you. Travel has been restricted as well. There are strict conditions for people who want to come out here. The only reason I was allowed to is because this isn't the first time I'm doing this job. The people here already know me. Heck, I didn't even know this was the town in question until I arrived and heard everyone talking about you. Well, I'm glad they are taking this matter seriously. Well, they certainly are. I'd like to know more about these cities you talked about, though. Well, I can only speak about the one I live in, but what do you want to know? I only really have this town as a point of reference, so why don't you tell me about what's different? Gee, that's only pretty much everything. Oh, hey, look! It's his space palm emoji! Out here, living in general seems to be a lot cheaper than it is in the city, and there is much more room for everything.
Cat! Fuck off! No! You don't get to come in here. Fuck off. Leave. Bye. 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 Motherfucker.
Bitch! There are green spaces, fields, parks, and farms. You don't really see that in the city. Metalcore slowly starts falling in love with Kevin secretly and starts cheating on Remy. Fuck it. Hang on, I got a... Animal abuse.
Incoming animal abuse.
Yeah. Fuck off. No. Bye. I truly don't think this cat understands the difference between getting kicked in the face and having the fucking... Poke with a stick. Stick poke. Get out. Come on. Get out. Poke you in the butt. I poke you in the butt. Even that doesn't work anymore.
Called police. Lol.
Fuck off. Leave. Get out. Come on. Leave. Bye. No. Fuck off.
Fucking shit. Called Bryce Cat Revenge? Don't be so rude to your mom, Maverick will eat you. Doubt it, just look how he treats the floofy creatures, even right now he's throwing stuff and chasing him away. Your mom just loves you. He's beating the cat with that stick? No, I'm not beating him, I'm just trying to get him to leave. Besides, he's a little cocksucker anyway. He's really rude. Little fucking piece of shit. All people here are more laid back and there's a bigger sense of community as everybody knows everybody. Which can be both good and bad. For example, rumors travel fast and survive well in areas like this one. In the city, you can just make new friends when that happens. But out here, a few well-placed stories could mean social death. In the city, it is also much more crowded. Buildings pretty much line the streets and there isn't much room for anything else. But with the clubbing scene and opportunities for socializing, there is no shortage of potential friends. There are also many different jobs and education opportunities that you wouldn't find out here. Like what? Oh, creative jobs of all kinds. For example, game designers, writers, artists, that kind of stuff. For a confirmed cocksucker, Kitty wants metal cock. It's a furry in disguise? I mean, I haven't denied it. Well, the same goes for teaching positions in those areas as well. For example, if I wanted to learn how to write a romance novel, I can find a course for that easily. Out here, this would be a lot more difficult. You know what I mean? Yes, absolutely. In a way, it feels like you're always busy when you live in the city. The streets are usually filled with people trying to get somewhere. Of course, this is also a side effect of the small apartments, as people tend to get out more often and seek entertainment elsewhere. Which do you prefer? In the end, I suppose I prefer the city. That's not to say that I think that one is better than the other. Different strokes for different folks and all that. You know, out here people would probably laugh at some of the things I do in my free time, but in the city you get enough like-minded people to even get conventions going about all kinds of things. What conventions do you go to? I like all kind of geeky things, cartoons, comics, and all that stuff. I've even written a few fanfics before too, since I can't really draw all that well. This guy is too fanservice-y! Pony Threat Simulator? Lol. Aren't cartoons usually for kids? That's like saying books are usually just for kids. Cartoons are just a medium. Of course, there are some that are aimed at kids, but there are cartoons for adults as well. Cartoons for adults. I see. The protagonist is skeptical of your claims. Not like that. Well, I mean, there are cartoons like that, but that wasn't what I was talking about. In any case, what else falls under geeky interest for you? Well, let's see. I guess you could say I'm kind of a techie. I do like following news about technology and hearing all about new developments in the industry. Oh, you must be pretty interested in the portal then. Oh, right, I didn't even consider that I could actually go there and check it out. If I knew where it was at, that is. I could show you. If you did that, you'd be like the coolest human I've ever met. I suppose you'd be that by default since you're also the only human I'd ever met, but you get the idea. Let's just go. I'll be right behind you. It looks gorgeous, by the way. That portal. There it is in all its glory. That looks so much cooler than I thought it would. Halt! State your business. I just wanted to show the portal to my friend here. Well, friend, you can look, but don't touch anything. And no photos either. We need more Kevin background check? I mean, I think we need to, you know, do a more thorough search of him. You know, see if there's anything under that fur of his. Do I look like I have a camera? Well, you could be hiding something in your fur. What did I just say? Are you going to give me a pat down? I don't think so. What's that, though? Flyers for a Midwest institution. I could give you one if you're interested in going back to school. No, thank you. I'm quite happy with my current job, which is protecting the portal from any unsavory individuals. What's up with you, Sebastian? Just doing my job, Metalcore. He could be a spy. I mean, he does look pretty weird. Really? There's been a lot of interest in the portal from the cities. They have made us offers, but for now we're not doing anything until we see how your visit turns out. In the end, it's just a political power struggle. Small towns like us have to protect our interests. And in the process, reinforce the stereotype of country bumpkins being conspiracy nuts. You know I could arrest you, right? Respect is a two-way street, just saying. Trust is good, but control is better. It's just a matter of perspective. I mean, he's not wrong. Well, I think I've seen enough here anyway. Let's head back, Metalcore. He is hiding his dingle-dangle in his fur. Check his fur, Metalcore. Sure. And I meant sure as in what he said in the game. You're not going to leak anything, are you? Of course not. Now that I think about it, I totally could, though. Oh, really? I have some connections and a potential audience. Now you're starting like to sound like Sebastian had a point. Not really, I just know a few people from writing a column in our college magazine. It got popular enough that it was even featured in the local newspaper for a while. Interesting. What did you write about? Nothing special, really. It was just commentary about current events. I see. I guess you were pretty involved in your local community then. Not more than anyone else, I think. What's it like to actually live on campus? College in general is a pretty unique period of life, I'd say. Something I've noticed is that some people are not prepared for the independence they have while living on campus. You're given a chaotic schedule where you have nothing to do on some days, whereas on others you are kept busy with classes, homework, and other things that you have to do. With study buddies, roommates, and classmates, it's really not hard to make new friends. Friendship makes me tired. You also get to meet a lot of new people who share similar interests from taking the same classes or being in the same clubs. And don't forget about the dorms, so all those people are always within reach, which can also be both good and bad. You can be tempted to hang out with friends when you should really be studying. For many people, it becomes the first taste of real freedom and independence. Some just handle it better than others, I suppose. Within a spur is a rift in time and space continuum, the fur is just the skies. Welp. That can be a problem with team projects, for example. There's always someone who ends up never showing up and not doing any part of the work. For me, it's not really a problem since I actually enjoy what I'm doing here. I don't mind the homework and sometimes I read up on subjects in advance so I don't get left behind. It's raising a fursuit. I've even cranked at the professor once or twice during a lecture. I think that wouldn't be a good idea with certain kinds of professors. Well, with ours, I was even allowed the privilege of giving a guest lecture for my own class once. Yeah, that's the kind of thing I was talking about. Come on, learning should be fun. It certainly is for me. I suppose being able to have that kind of attitude makes it a lot easier. It certainly does. Let's see if it keeps up once you have a few more semesters under your non-existent belt. Don't be so negative, and just for your information, I do have a belt at home. Oh, you do? Really? You kinky fucker. Besides, it's not as if I'm some sort of antisocial hermit who only focuses on his studies. I just know when to say no to my friends. Oh, really? Yes, we usually get together on the weekends and do some cooking together. People can only stand so much frozen food before they get sick of it, and eating out in the city can add up pretty quickly if you're not careful. I see. We rotate the cook every few weeks. We rotate the cook every week, but apparently people are looking forward to when it's my turn. I've gotten a lot of compliments for my homemade mac and cheese. Now you're making me hungry. I bet they all miss it, but they'll get to taste it again once summer vacation is over in a month or so. And in the meantime, you're just here handing out flyers? Yep, it's good to help out our college, and I can also save up a bit in the process. It's certainly easier than trying to juggle a job and homework at the same time later on if things get tight. What were you studying again? Psychology. I see. Cooking, quote unquote? Yeah. Alright, go ahead and analyze me right now. It doesn't really work like that. I know, you just passed the test. Oh, I know what you're getting at. Maybe I'll steal that test from you, though. Might be worth trying it out on a few people I know. Be my guest. On a more serious note, tell me something about what you're learning. What, anything? This fucker had me at mac and cheese? I just want to get an idea of the subject and whether it's comparable to our own understanding of psychology. I see. Well, I could tell you about an old and very simplified model of our psyche that we got taught in introductory class. The special ingredient for the mac and cheese is hair. Sounds good. Okay, so this model divides our psychic apparatus into three distinct parts, called id, ego, and superego. Oh god, we're getting into this. The id represents our most basic desires and instinctual drives. That is, our physical needs and wants, like hunger and thirst, as well as desires and impulses. I have already gone through all of this sort of stuff, psychology. Because I actually am quite interested in stuff like psychology, even though I'm a fucking computer science student. I like to do it in my spare time. What's the difference? An impulse is more like wanting to lash out in anger, for example. The id seeks out immediate gratification for these urges. It is in conflict with the superego, which represents learned behavior like cultural and moral rules and societal standards. The kind of stuff we learn from our role models like parents, teachers, or guardians. The superego is the part that forms our conscience and controls our sense of right and wrong. It seeks to uphold these standards to perfection, which most of the time goes against what the id wants at any given moment. Kevin, is the idea of metalcore? No. Oh, you sound like you had to rote learn a lot of this. If those internalized rules are broken, this misbehavior is punished by the superego with feelings of guilt and shame. This way, we are compelled to behave in accordance to these rules, even if the id tempts us to do so otherwise. And in between these two conflicting parts of us, there is the ego who is trying to meditate. Freud will be so proud. It represents our rational mind that seeks to pleasure that seems to that It represents our rational mind that seeks to please the id's drives in a way that doesn't harm us or goes against the superego's goals. However, it also serves another master, the external world. The ego includes all of our decision making and how we respond to external stimuli. Ultimately, it is the one calling the shots while trying to balance the needs of the id, the superego, and the external world. And there you have it, an outdated, simplified model of our psyche. It still serves as a good introduction, though. Thank you. Actually, I think I may have heard about something like this before. Why did you go with psychology in particular? Fuck! My voice! I'm just interested in how people work, I suppose. Oh, we're not so different on that fucking level. Well, it's also an incredibly diverse subject, and so are the potential jobs. I'd rather have Anna stick things inside me. Lenny face. Just being able to understand people is such a huge factor in many fields, and the skills you can learn can come in handy in all areas of life, really. That is true. When people hear about psychology, most people think of psychologists or psychotherapists, but they can also be counselors for communities and organizations, researchers, or teachers. You also often see them teaming up with other professionals to influence every part of society. Just think about hospitals, courtrooms, prisons, even school and universities. They can also become coaches for high-performance jobs when they work with CEOs, athletes, and performers of all kinds. Every institution and every business that works with people can profit from the presence of someone who has studied psychology. That's why you'll also find this kind of knowledge to be incredibly helpful even when you are a manager or in sales, because those jobs require empathy and understanding of your client's needs. Why not study, Anna? Understanding people is just something that can come in handy pretty much wherever you go, and that's what psychology is all about. Erlenmeyer flasks up your nose? God damn it, Adolwyn. Oh, even in video games, psychology is a factor. Horror games are an obvious example, but also with tutorials or UI design and how people interact with your game, psychology and player expectations are always going to be a factor. I think I get the idea. Out here, I think a lot could still be done to improve the image of the field, you know? What do you mean? Oh, there's a bit of a stigma to admitting that you need help, especially when you're doing fine physically. Yep. For them, it's a sign of weakness, so in order to preserve their image, they hide everything away. But locking away those feelings doesn't solve the problem. If anything, it only makes it worse. Is that something you'd like to work with? Me, honestly, I don't know if I could tackle a big issue like that. It's good for me that psychology is such a diverse field, because I'm not quite sure where I'm going with it yet, or what particular job I'd like to have after I'm done with my studies. I see. I think you have plenty of time to figure that out. Yep, before I came here for my summer job, I was interning at a psychotherapist's office for a month. I got to hear about some very interesting and also tragic cases. It would start a war between them on who gets dominance over who studies who. I thought I wanted to help people with issues like that, but sometimes it's pretty hard not to be affected too much by those stories. So I'm not sure if that's the right job for me. Shut up and fuck me, Kevin! No! But you're already like working with people, right? I don't know. Maybe interning there was a little too close to the sun for me. Well, if you didn't, why would you be the one to hand out the flyers? It's just like you mentioned earlier, psychology comes in handy with sales and similar jobs where you have to interact with people. Handing out flyers is pretty similar to that, don't you think? I guess. Or you seem to be doing well enough with that. You're helping to bring people to your college and people together, and in this way you're helping both. And it's been a lot of fun too. After all, I got to meet you and even got a glimpse of the portal. Who knows, maybe one of those people you handed a flyer will one day turn out to be famous for their work. Now I think that's a little too idealistic, but I get your point. It doesn't always have to be about big problems. Little problems need solving too. Like what you're reading on the weekend. Haha, yeah. What about you though? He would talk even when fucking? Knowing him, yeah. Well, what do you mean? Well, I don't want to pry, but we've been talking all this time, and you know a lot more about me than I know about you. Maybe you can't say anything about where you grew up or what you studied because it's top secret or whatever, but I'd be lying if I said I wasn't curious. Well, I don't like talking about myself all that much, and I think there are some things that are better left unsaid. I see. But if you're curious, I guess it's only fair I share a few things as well. Give sex at class while in the middle of sex? You know, it's been fun talking about college. I already got my degrees a while ago. It was interesting to go hunting for jobs with my unusual combination of degrees, but I thought that would open a few doors. But before I got anywhere, our world underwent a few changes that made a lot of jobs obsolete. It's been a rough time since then. Turns out those degrees came in handy after all, because in the end, they enabled to get me here. Imagine attending Dragon College when you are the only human in the lecture. Well, if I consider all the good and bad that's happened here since my arrival, it's been a vacation compared to home. And it looks like the vacation might come to an end soon. I don't know what's going to happen after that. I can only hope my visit here will have started something that will mean change for our world. But I'm not sure if that's going to happen. I shouldn't be such a downer though. Sorry for bringing it up, but maybe that explains why I don't like talking about it. What's your professional opinion on this? Well, in my professional opinion as a flyer distributor, I'd recommend a generous application of hugs, but that's just me. You just look like you could need them. Go for it. He took a step forward, and I soon found myself being enveloped in a furry dragon's embrace. With him pulling me close, it felt like a giant furry blanket was all around me as the hairs tickled my exposed skin. This shout quickly turned NSFD, not safe for dragons. Well, after a few seconds, we parted, and he took a step back again. I hope things can be better for you in the future. I don't think I can do anything to help with that, though. I know, you prefer the little problems. It's getting dark. I should probably head out and look for a cave, or else I'll have to sleep in the streets. What are you talking about? Well, it seems like all the hostels are already full. Despite the vetting process for visitors, enough people got in to take all the available short-term lodging spots in this town. Oh, really? Yes, despite only a few people knowing your location or that of the portal, journalists and tourists are flocking to the towns, hoping to catch a glimpse, or at least find a clue of your whereabouts. That only leaves me with the option of finding or renting a cave for the night, or sleeping in the streets. Not that I'd mind sleeping in a cave, but for someone like me, it's usually something for an adventurous weekend rather than a way of life. And rocks don't exactly make for the best bedding. Well, you could sleep here. Metalcore will be picking hairs off himself for a while? Yes. Oh, you could sleep here, man. Really? Yeah, there's plenty of room here, and it's kind of my fault that you couldn't find another place anyway. I guess that means you don't share the officer's suspicions about me being a spy then. Not really. You know, I could totally take this room apart while you're sleeping. You're not helping your case there. Besides, you won't really find anything special here. Hey, I'd keep an eye on that copy of Draconic Desire you've got on the shelf there. I might be tempted to snatch it when you're not looking. Like I'd mind. If you need something for bedtime reading, feel free to help yourself. Oh, I will. It makes me uncomfortable. You met with Kevin and learned a lot about city and college life. Now you're prepared for a possible life at a dragon college, I guess. Don't let Kevin eat kitty! Oh, I would totally let Kevin eat the kitty. Okay, well, I'm gonna get some rest, and we're gonna do the neutral ending. That should be fucking fun! Ba-da-da-da-dun! The chapter 5. And this time there's no dead dragon, there are no gunshots! Woohoo! Yeah, boy! That makes me happy. I was sleeping with Kevin? He didn't sleep with me, he slept on the couch. Kevin likes Dragon Twilight, sequel incoming. Who shall I bring? Okay, here we are going to save so we can get back to it easily. Hang on, this is going to be my penultimate save here. We are going to go alone and then probably the everyone will be for another time. While I was sure any of those I knew would agree to watch the fireworks with me if I asked, I ultimately decided to go alone, not wanting to impose on anyone if they hadn't asked me first. After making some preparations for the day, I set out to experience these fireworks I had heard so much about. Dump them now? Rip. When I left my apartment, I realized just how eerily deserted the place felt. They really weren't kidding when they said everyone would watch the fireworks. I imagine there were a couple of designated places people gathered for this purpose. I had no doubt they were crowded beyond belief. While I waited for the fireworks to start, I looked at the area around me. With no soul in sight, I realized I hadn't actually spent many nights outside and was reminded of the day I had arrived here at my apartment in total darkness, with only Remy by my side. The fucking feels, bro! The feels! Soon, the total stillness was broken with the sound of the first rocket ascending. The explosion painted a circular pattern in the sky. More rockets followed, their quantity and frequency steadily increasing.
Ooh,
Ooh, pretty fireworks. As the explosions battered my ears, a terrible realization hit me. And all this sort of shit. You slept in your house, therefore you slept with Kevin? I ran to my apartment and briefly considered calling the police as I grabbed a few things. However, I soon remembered that they were not already understaffed, but that I might waste precious time if I tried to do so. Und wir at the portal now, there is no dead Sebastian there! Woohoo! The stove turned off and it appeared to be used, he was still around. There was a suitcase leaning against the portal. When I opened to check on its contents, I was surprised to find a few eggs inside. I had no doubt that this was Razor's doing. Wait, how does he have the eggs? Apparently he had broken into the hatchery again. Stashing the eggs here, but he hadn't used the portal just yet. Why? Given that he hadn't left yet, he clearly still had unfinished business in the area. The underground building, the administrator had told me all about the prowess of the generators within. It probably hadn't been hard for Razor to guess the same, or to try stealing them from a place he knew would be even more deserted than the rest of the village was right now. He also didn't have far to go from the portal. All things considered, it was the only option that made sense to me. I could have waited for Razor here, but in the end I decided it would be better to meet him underground. If there was going to be a confrontation, I was sure I would have had the advantage. I would have the advantage in a more crowded space. Eggs, nom nom nom, pancakes? Lol. Even in the darkness, it was easy for me to spot the site where they had unearthed the building's entry, as it was in a roped-off area that I had seen from afar before. When I entered the building, I was met by a long and illuminated hallway that was lined with doors on both sides. Had to be very close. Lord Cardboard's box, he spotted me sat on the ground. Someone telling you the whole time. Hey, we got everything, okay, let's get out of here. No. Until they answer a few questions. Got a few hours. And then all this bullshit. Yeah, all this stuff. Okay, I mean, we have already seen this pretty much. Truth. Okay. I mean, like I said, this is what I... Okay, this... Bend like that. Okay, well, we've already done all this. Yeah, I know this. I already know all this. I know this. There he giggles again. Wait. What? I opened the cloak I was wearing to reveal an improvised bomb I had made from a generator. Excuse me? What is this? Oh, you showed me how to deal with the little trap you set at the farmhouse. That wasn't intended for you. Well, it doesn't matter. You set it for someone. You set it to kill. Where'd you even get a generator? After the police reclaimed the generators you stole, it was easy for me to take one when I was alone in the department, just in case. I set the bomb on the ground between us. With it and me between Ray's and the exit, he would have to listen to me now. So, what's the plan? I'll tell you what's going to happen. You lead the generator and turn yourself in. You know what? I think you're bluffing. If you set off that bomb, not only do we both die, but you destroy the generators as well, and with them any chance of saving either world. You would never do that. He pulled out his gun and pointed at me as he slowly started closing the distance between us. What's it going to be, Metalcore? Killing all of us? Or just this world? Reza was right. In reality, the bomb provided no real leverage against him. If his goal was truly to save our city back home at any cost, he would not turn himself in. Even if the threat of setting off the bomb was a real one, his best chance would be to at least try to kill me now. I turned around and started running. No! I heard gunshots. Immediately, I felt the most excruciating pain I've ever experienced resonate through my arm. As I kept sprinting as fast as I could, I heard a beeping sound that made me realize I had inadvertently activated the bomb when I was hit. Out of bullets, Reza was not far behind me as we both scrambled towards the exit. Just as I reached the outside, the bomb went off. The explosion battered my ears as the shockwave sent me flying. I collided with the ground and immediately felt a hail of the breeze. I cowered, waiting for it to die down. After a few seconds and looked at the sky where the fireworks still painted patterns in the stars. With one hand, I reached toward my injured arm, only to find it wet with blood from my bullet wound. My whole body was numb. But I could not give up now. I slowly got up, looking around the area to get some perspective of the situation. Not far from where I was, I saw Reza lying on the ground. He wasn't moving. Ooh, yeah, he's dead. Rip. Double tap him just to be sure. As I got closer, I spotted the gun next to him. I won't let them find this. I took it with me, hiding it in one of my pockets as I started making my way towards the portal with slow and uneasy steps. I was shaking and my vision was blurry. Every inch of movement felt like a new and harder chore than the last. Eventually, my legs gave in and I collapsed to the ground. So is this where we die? Is this how this ends? I resigned to my fate as I watched the night sky, illuminated by the colorful explosions of the fireworks. Suddenly I was lifted off the ground and as I opened my eyes, I saw the masked face of the administrator. I just could not let it happen. I had to stop him. I had to try. Somehow. The administrator started moving, carrying me. Unfortunately, it seems like the generators were destroyed as well. So this is how it ends, with humanity doomed to fade into history, and the dragons facing extinction? All hope is not lost. It never was. What are you going to do? I'm going to send you back in time. We'll just try again, and maybe we'll do better next time. By now, we had arrived at the portal. The administrator gently set me down before moving to the portal's controls. You'll probably forget most of what happens. The teleportation tends to do that sometimes, especially when someone is transported several times in quick succession. Maybe you'll remember a thing or two, and maybe they'll help you do better next time. Maybe. I'll see you on the other side. Hello from the other side. I heard the sound of the portal starting to do its work, as the numbness and pain suddenly left my body. Things I had experienced and things I hadn't flashed across, my mind as I was teleported. I felt free. That played automatically. Damn it. So Reza is now the deads. I'm gravely injured and we are once again going back in time. Yeah, and I think I am going to have to leave it at only this. So after this, you have the evil and true end left, right? Yeah, pretty much. And then, you know, something along the lines of, you know, doing an asshole run and finding a few other scenes that some people would not like to see, but I am very curious as to how to get them. And it's going to make me feel like killing myself for the next few weeks, but it'll be fine. Just to be able to experience what it is. I want this game to violate me in every fucking way. To violate and caress my butt cheeks in every single way. Umera butt? Ugh. Gallery? Yes, I know. I'm not going to skip this, though. But yeah, we just fucking Alua Akbar'd pretty badly. Which is, interesting. But yeah, I will most certainly be checking out the gallery. Razor is dead for the 10th time. Gallery! Yes, Night Sky, I know! Shut up! Give a rating for each dragon butt? You would have to give me some time to think about it. Your only two ending options here are evil and true. Evil is you offending Bryce, Adine, Anna, Lorem, and Remy, then going alone when they don't want. Everyone is the true ending. Okay. And like I said, I will be doing some other endings and dialogue trees that will lead to some interesting situations. You have seen the neutral ending. Detonation. Like Umair and Bryce did already then? Oh look, we have them as well now. Look at that. Everyone's here now. Okay, the gallery. I am really interested. Holy fuck, this is suddenly filled. Oh, there we have little police dinosaur. He's just like, oh, you come here, you motherfucker. This guy, he knows what's up. Look at him being a little badass right there. Oh, there we have Zong, who is giving a gift. That is, that's cute. Definitely cute. There we have Umira, who refuses to look at me even to this fucking day. Not that I'd want to anyway. There we have Zong eating some ice cream. Said the suicide buff so it was not that unsuccessful. Oh, look at this guy. Oh, look at this guy. I like his jacket. That leather's good. That's some good leather right there. Okay, so now we only have, well, I guess the true ending. I'm guessing this is the true ending and then the evil ending. Kinda don't want to, you know. But the present to his son is like, oh, it's so adorable! Look in bottom left corner of the screen again. Oh, that's Katsu. Oh, look at that. The gun's even there. Katsu is ice cream. Shut up. Look at that. There's a gun there. That's awesome. These guys don't get to have shadows, though. That's unfortunate. Katsu is so freaking large. I mean, yeah, he's fat. I have gotten 51 out of 63 achievements. Damn, son! That's a lot of stuff. So, yeah, tomorrow, 11 is evil, 12 is true. Okay, well, yeah, like I said, called it. Yeah, this game has been a fucking amazing experience. You know, it has certainly been a clusterfuck of emotions, you know. Roller coaster like a mofo. Which is nice. You know, like I said, you know, not a lot of games can actually make me feel in such a fashion. So the fact that this game managed to do it as much as it did is kind of a feat in itself. So Metacore confirms it gave a song? No. No. So yeah, that's all I basically have to say. Also, if you guys fucking look at this. This video has gotten more views. Remy's Root has gotten more views than Anna's Root, Lorem's Root, and Bryce's Root. Although it hasn't yet caught up to Adine yet. But I mean, with how fast this fucker's been growing, I think that will... Metacore's gay for Kevin? I mean, I think this one might even overtake this one, and this one has already got 704 views. 23 watches, I think that's the most I've seen during the playthrough so far. I mean, I think we have broken it a little bit later, by a little bit. But I mean, yeah, these streams have been really fun, and they've been, you know, rather popular. So yeah, I'm really glad that you guys, you know, wanted to join me on this adventure. More like an emotional freefall tower sometimes? Yeah, I guess. Okay, so, well, I basically don't have anything else to say. Right, next stream. Most likely not tomorrow. Because I will have to do some stuff tomorrow. And I will most likely be eating late, which will cause me to be incapable to stream tomorrow. So, probably, the last endings, and maybe those other endings, will be on... a Wednesday. Let me see. I'll have to check my schedule, actually. Let me look at that real quick. There's an internal server error. God fucking damn it! There we go. Let me see. How's a Wednesday looking? That looks doable. Okay, so like I said, most likely Wednesday, otherwise Thursday. And I will be off on a Friday. Do you hope there's a sequel in the future? Of course. And I would like for the sequel to actually even be better than this one. If it can manage that. To be honest, I don't think it would. Create a set of the game does well. I mean, I hope this game's doing well. I mean, it's getting plenty of attention. I mean, we all fucking hope for for a fucking sequel. But like I said, I am very hesitant to think that it will live up to this great of this high of a level, because this game was really good. But the problem is, you cannot just do everything that has been done already again. So it would be really difficult, and if the guy manages it, I will be really fucking surprised, and I will, you know, hats off to him. I might even make a new Steam account just to buy the game again. You know, just to show my appreciation. Detailed romance scenes, NSFW option. I mean, I have my own complaints about the game, but I will do a whole separate review giving all my thoughts and criticisms of this game in hopefully an as constructive way as possible. If more feels than this would be healthy, I mean, I don't even think if that's possible. Like I said, this game was very confronting in a lot of its stuff. And I mean, there's not a whole lot of things you can actually, there's not a whole lot of things you can do with it. But I mean, I will be looking for it if it will exist regardless. And I will, of course, be playing it. And if it comes out, I will, of course, be streaming it with you guys. Yeah, that is really all that I have to say for now. Like I said, probably stream on Wednesday. I might do another stream on Thursday then, just depending on how it goes. I'm not sure if I will be doing any other streams on it. I mean, you guys will have to tell me of any other possibilities. Just go for like a fun run, just saying whatever the fuck you want to, get some of the, the weird dialogue stuff, or if you just, if you guys don't really care about that. Yeah, so that is all I have to say. All bad endings in one combined? Oh, hells no. Dude, I would not survive that. But yeah, like I said, thank you all so much for watching. Be sure to like, favorite, comment, subscribe. Go down into the description. There's a link to, the game's unofficial Discord server, which is run by us. You can join there and you can, come and chat to us. We're always chatting it up in there, talking about the game, talking about other stuff. It's always a lot of fun in there. So be sure to go join that. That's one of the links in the description. There's links to my social media, Facebook, Twitter, Twitch, my own personal Discord server, which is pretty much dead at the moment. And yeah, go do all that fun stuff. And like I said, next stream on a Wednesday. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next stream. Peace.